Hey car fans, Dinosaurs Rex here. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I want to talk to you about something that's important to me. Behind me is my first car. Well, I say my first car. My first car was actually a 98 two-door Neon, and this is a 2000 four-door. My first car, I was turning left on the top of an overpass, and some guy came up over the hill. He was going 70 and a 40 in an uninsured borrowed truck with a suspended license, and hit the B pillar and caved in the whole side of the car. I remember screaming, spinning, and trying to look in the side mirror to see the damage, and then like a minute later, it took me a minute to realize that I couldn't see it because the mirror was no longer attached to the car. So that's what happened to my first car. That was Mouse. It was forest green, two-door, 98 Neon. After that, as you might imagine, someone who had just learned how to drive at 18, not 16, was scared of driving, anxious, nervous, and not quite sure what to get as far as my next car. I had taken driver's ed, and I had learned to drive in a 2000 Dodge Neon with a sunroof. It was red, and I really loved that car, mainly because it was so, like, it was small inside. I have this thing about being in vehicles where if the vehicle is so much bigger than me, I get anxiety from the car being too big. So I liked that the Neon was short and small, kind of like me. I think I was without a car for at least a month, but I was going to get another, I think it was a 99, it was a silver one, and I went to my regular car dealership and had him check it out. That's where I'd been getting my oil changes, and he was freaking out. He said, "Don't buy this car." Not that there was anything wrong with the car, but he really wanted to sell me a car. So what he offered to do is to go to an auction and get me any car I wanted. The only car I wanted, he said, you could get a truck, you could get a brand new Avenger, you could get whatever you want. The only car I wanted was a 2000 Dodge Neon. And it was between this one and I think, I don't remember what color the other one was. But it's a very, very similar color to the car that my grandparents had. This is cranberry metallic, or was when it was brand new. So anyway, he went to the auction and he got me this and said he would help me fix it up, do whatever needed to be done to it. And the rest, as you can see clearly, is history. I have had this car since 2001. Just a short while after my accident. It was built in 99 in the fall. So this year, this fall, this car will be turning 20 years old. And it has been with me for 18 of those 20 years. And the reason I'm filming it today, you might notice I look kind of tired, dirty, I'm even sweaty a little bit. It's Florida and it's 80 degrees. But today was wash the car day. And I hadn't really, it's been driven through like an automatic car wash, but it hadn't had the get down on your knees and scrub the brake dust off the rims kind of hand washing that it needed probably since I got sick in 2015. So there was moss growing on the back of the car, and there was some kind of white stuff growing inside where the gas cap was, and when I was washing it just now, it kind of made me feel like, it made me feel good, and it made me feel bad. Bad because I have not been taking care of it as well as I used to, and good because of the connection I have with the car. When I was sitting here washing the car, and I don't know why, I took like 2 hours to hand scrub my car to get everything off of it. There's still some work to do, and I still need to detail the inside. I did clean all the trash out and all that, but I even took a tiny little brush about this size and scrubbed the brake dust on the rims. So it's not perfect by any means, but it's a lot better than it was. And there's no moss. But, oh, here comes the Jeep. You can see the Jeep drive by in a minute. It's my neighbor. Anyway, yeah, so I mean, I was thinking about the car, and like, the car and I, it's not just a car, you know? Like, if you take care of your vehicle, then it will take care of you and it will last you this long. We're headed towards 200,000 miles. I think it's at 189 something. But like, I have the picture when it clocked over to 100,000 miles and 150,000 miles. I have all the paperwork, the service manuals, the everything that was supposed to come with it. I have that. My husband got me rims when we were dating, and a spoiler, because I'd always wanted that, and we put that on the car. And it's been on there so long in the Florida sun, it now matches the peeling clear of the rest of the car. So it's just about time to do a rebuild and a repaint. You know, as soon as we get the Jeep mostly done, we still got to do the rims. The motor mounts are here, we just got to put them in. We're working on getting the Challenger out of the body shop and into the garage for assembly. And after that, my time will be free to maybe work on the car a little bit. But anyway, I was thinking about, you know, like, basically this was my first car. I didn't have the other one long, like a semester or maybe a semester and a half. It wasn't that long. I was coming home from college when the accident happened. And anyway, so, I mean, like, this was my first car. It's my college car. I commuted to college instead of staying at the dorm, so I drove it every single day. We have slid in the snow. We have done donuts. We have hydroplaned. We have driven everywhere. I've driven this car to Wisconsin, from Indiana to Wisconsin, Chicago. I've driven this car from Indiana to Florida multiple times. I've driven this car. This is the car that I got in and after film school and went out to California in, and it did not like California at all. It came from California and I thought, sure, it'll be no problem. Wrong part of California. Hills are not a good thing for this car. But, you know, and like after film school, I moved every summer for 5 years, mostly in this car. So, I mean, I named the car Gabriel. Gabriel and I have been through basically everything. This is the car I was driving when I started dating my husband. It's the car I took the kids to school in when I took my brother's kids to school. It's literally everything. Every road trip, every time I've gone anywhere. We've driven it to Kansas and back to see the family. It's just been the most reliable car I've ever known. I can't tell you how many times, like, we have Chevys for work for trucks because we need the hauling power, and I can't tell you how many times I've had to get in this car and rescue the guys in the Chevy and take them to the shop or whatever to get parts to fix the Chevy because the Chevy's broke, and this 20-year-old monstrosity is still running and still working. Now, it does have nicks and scratches, it has some rust, it has some dents, it has some problems, but I know every single one. Like, I know, like, the dent on one side is from a hood being dropped on, and the dent on the other side is from somebody slamming into my door, and the chip on the back is when the guy rear-ended me not too long ago, and then, like, there's a bump on the front. I know what that's from. I know every nick, every scratch. When I went to college, someone keyed my car, and that really really PO'd me. But luckily, when I met my husband, we had a friend that was doing body work, and he was able to buff the scratches out. Now, they didn't come completely out, but at least it doesn't have a swear word on the side of my car anymore. But I mean, like, when he did that, he burnt clear a little bit on the side. So, like, but I know what that's from. every, like, I know when the gas cover got nicked. I know when it started burning oil in between oil changes. I have a service log where I wrote down every time, like, all the mileage through college, every time I had the oil changed, all the major stuff that's been done to it. I have that. I know that. And if you think about the way people treat their cars these days, people don't do that usually. I mean, they track mileage for tax reasons sometimes, but unless you're like a car guy, you don't keep track of your service records and stuff. But you should. You absolutely should, because, I mean, I'm never going to sell this car, mainly because I would not trust anyone else to take care of it. It's like, it's my car. Traffic. It's my car. It's my baby. I am he. He is me. We go together. It's funny. I just have so many funny stories about my car. You know, driving with every person I've ever been in love with, and like I said, every kid I took to school, and riding in it with my grandparents when I learned how to drive, and showing them my car when I got my second car, and just memories, layers and layers and layers of memories. And I guess the point of all this is take care of your car. It's not the mileage or the years, it's the maintenance. If you take care of your car, then your car will take care of you. You'll be giving people rides to the auto parts store in your perfectly working car, especially if it's a Dodge. And dare I say it, if it's a Neon like mine that's been taken care of, you're in pretty good shape. I mean, like I said, it does need some things, but knock on wood, no major catastrophic mechanical problems. It's a good car. It's just a good car. Dodge, if you're watching, why did you stop making this beautiful, amazing little car? Women in particular, like me, love the Dodge Neon. It was cheap. It was just a little bit fancy. It got us around. Had decent speed, decent acceleration. It's 20 years old. It gets 26 miles to the gallon, which it used to get 30 or 32, but that was highway driving and college and stuff. But, you know, 26 miles per gallon on a 20-year-old vehicle, that's better than my husband's 06 truck that gets like 14, 15. That's better than the Jeep that gets maybe 18 on a good day. It's a good little car, and I hope that whatever car you have, you treat it well, and it will treat you as well as this car has treated me. So, that's pretty much it for today. I just wanted to share that with you because I've been bonding with my car for 2 hours. And, yeah. I guess until next time, I'll see you on the road.